We want to solve the given trig equation on the interval from 0 to 2 pi, where it's closed on 0 and open on 2 pi. So it looks like a pretty straightforward equation. Let's go ahead and add 0.32 to both sides. We'll have sine x equals 0.32. So we want to determine the angles on this interval where the sine function would equal 0.32. Now this sine function value is not going to result in a nice reference angle or reference triangle. So we'll have to use the calculator to help us solve this equation. If we take inverse sine of both sides of the equation, the left side simplifies to our angle x, and the right side we have inverse sine 0.32. Remember, when we have inverse sine of sine x, these two functions undo each other and we're left with x. Remember, on the unit circle, sine theta is equal to y. So the sine function is positive in both the first and second quadrants. The reason that's important is the output of inverse sine is on the interval from negative pi over 2 to positive pi over 2, where the terminal side is in the first and fourth quadrants. So the calculator will not give us all of the solutions to this equation, but it will get us started. Let's check to make sure we're in radian mode, and we are. So now we'll press second sine for inverse sine, 0.32 or just 0.32. And so one of the solutions to this equation is when x is equal to approximately 0.326 radians. Which would be an angle in the first quadrant, so it might look something like this. Let's go ahead and label this radians. But now we also have to determine which angle in the second quadrant would also have the same sine function value. Well, the angle would have a reference angle of 0.326 radians, which means the terminal side of the other angle would have to look something like this. Again, where this reference angle is 0.326 radians. So to determine the measure of this angle in the second quadrant, or this angle here, we'll have to take pi radians and then subtract 0.326 radians. So it'll be pi minus 0.326 radians for our second solution. So the angle in the second quadrant is approximately 2.816 radians. So when using the calculator to determine the solution to a trig equation, it is important that you make sure you get all of the solutions on the given interval.